Now we will briefly discuss reports, but first, let's look at the Measures tab. One thing I forgot to mention last time, if you don't already have it installed, is the OpenStudio Results Measures. There are two different reports that you can output in addition to custom reports, but these are good default reports to use initially. The EnergyPlus output report is automatically generated, so we don't have to add a measure there. You already see that we did output an additional diagnostic report here. Also, there is an OpenStudio results report that can be found on the building component library online. If you go to reporting drop-down QAQC, and you can simply drag and drop OpenStudio results into place. If you do not already have this, you can find it on the building component library by clicking the Find Measures on BCL button, as we discussed in previous examples. Next, let's go to the Results Summary tab on the left. There are two different results reports that have been created for this model. The OpenStudio results, and then you can also click the drop down here at the top and change it to the EnergyPlus results. Both of these reports are created in an HTML file. If you browse to the folder, the project folder, OpenStudio project folder, open it, go to reports, and you will see the EnergyPlus report and the OpenStudio results report. Let's open the OpenStudio results report. It opens in a standard web browser. The OpenStudio results report is a summary of a lot of information about the energy model. It is not as comprehensive as the EnergyPlus report, but it's a little bit easier to read. Starting at the top, it starts with summary information about the building. Then it goes to weather summary, sizing period, design days. This has to do with the design day file that we inputted at the very beginning of the model. These are all the assumptions used for auto sizing the equipment. Next, there is an unmet hours summary. This is a good summary to look at. If you have unmet hours in your building, it tells you that there might be something wrong with equipment sizing, space loads, or schedules that are overlapping. Next, the unmet hours tolerance shows the tolerance used for reporting the unmet hours. And if you want to go into further detail with unmet hours, you can go to zone conditions. Click the zone conditions in the table of contents on the left. Here you can see unmet heating hours on the left and unmet cooling hours on the right. And this table shows you a range of temperatures that the spaces experience throughout the entire year. If some of the spaces, for example, thermal zone 103, fall below the heating set point for a certain number of hours, that's considered an unmet hour, especially if it's an unmet occupied hour. Going back to the top, past unmet hours, you have an annual overview with various tables showing end uses for various equipment, end uses for utilities, end uses for electricity and gas. And then you also have monthly overview tables showing you total usages for electricity and natural gas in monthly time steps. And then if you have district equipment, you would also see those tables as well on a monthly basis. It's showing district equipment in this example because we assigned ideal air loads to our thermal zones. As discussed before, ideal air loads assume an unlimited heating and cooling capacity based on a district heating or cooling system. Next, we can see peak demands for electricity and natural gas on a monthly basis, and same thing for district heating and cooling. We did not input any energy bills, utility bills, so none of that information is shown. Next, it goes into an envelope summary, space type breakdowns. This can show you the various space types located throughout your building. For example, the apparatus bay takes up 39% of our building and is approximately 2.3 thousand square feet of area. If you hover over each square, you can see its statistics. Next, going down, it goes into space summary details. For example, this closed office. It'll show you people definitions, electric, lights, infiltration, and ventilation. If you go to interior lighting, same thing. It shows you statistics for interior lighting. Lighting power densities and total power. Plug loads is the same. Exterior lighting, you will recall that we added those exterior lights with an astronomical clock. Next, the HVAC load profiles show you heating and cooling loads on a monthly basis with comparison to the outdoor air temperature. And then the zone conditions tab, as we discussed previously, with the range of temperatures located within the spaces throughout the year, in addition to the unmet heating and cooling hours. There's also a humidity table for buildings that are located in humidity-sensitive areas of the country. Next, you can go to the zone overview table. This gives additional statistics on each of the zones. Envelope, lighting, people, and plug loads. The zone equipment table is not shown in this example because we assigned ideal air loads to this project. So we don't have actually any zone equipment. Same with the air loops or plant loops. There's also an outdoor air table that shows outdoor air ventilation air statistics. We do not have a cash flow table because we did not input any utility bills or cost information in the project. And finally, there's a site and source summary table for the entire building. And lastly, there are schedules. This shows the schedules that we created for the various different loads and temperature set points, lighting, and occupancies. You can hover over the tables and it will show you what the values are. For example, if we wanted to know specifically what this laundry activity schedule is, we can hover over the table and it shows us that it's 132 watts per person. Same thing with the cooling HVAC thermostat. During the occupied portion of the day, it's set for 75 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's the OpenStudio results. Let's look at the EnergyPlus results. They are a lot more comprehensive. If you want to find the table of contents at any place in the report, you can just click the table of contents link on the right-hand side. Again, it shows a lot of that information that we saw in the OpenStudio results, plus a lot of additional information if you really want to get deep into the model. Thank you, and please like and subscribe.